enough of their own emotional crap. They can see the shape of the horse she could be, or she's going to be. There is no reason for a horse like this to run around with its head up in the air. No reason at all. Matter of fact, it's no damn good to me until it's prepared there. That's a good thing. She lowered her head into my hand. Now, the rub's for her. Before, the rub was for you, just to make you think I was a nice fox. Make sense? Until she gives it, until she wants it, that rub's not comfortable. It's only comfortable if she wants it. It's like water. Not comfortable if they're not thirsty. Food, they're always bloody hungry. Let's look at that jaw again. It's all pretty stuck. First up, your horse can't use its back end while it's not released in the pole. Now she can start to use a bar and a hocks. See her bum rounder, her back's higher, her loins will come up. Your horse can't do that while the head's stuck up in the air. What a kid. Come on up. What else are we going to do? Back up. Keep backing. Keep going. Keep going. Forward. Come forward. Quick. No, no. I'm only telling you to hurry up. Hey, young girl. I don't want this rope to be something she runs from. I wanted to run to it sometimes. If I tell her to back up, the rope says, hurry up. If I tell her to come forward, the rope should say, hurry up. It shouldn't be something she's fearful enough of to run away from. Make sense? Are we winning? Yes, if you've got flexion, you won't get kicked so hard. And you'll know when the horse can't stand it because you'll take the flexion out to straighten up again. Make sense? Lateral flexion is your friend, guys. We had a couple of hours, we'd ride. Yeah. But we haven't. She's sort of getting along as far as she needs to, but she could easily be ridden tonight.
But for the owner,
how long is that?
That's like Howell's piece of string.
How much ground skills are you prepared to do? How much preparation time are you prepared to do? And if you don't want to do ground skills or preparation time, just climb on. I don't care. Not my horse.
We'll be doing
horse things,
don't worry.
Do you get what I'm trying to say, guys? If you don't have the investment to develop a horse, drive the Bronco. I don't care. I do care. She's worth spending some time with her. But try and tell some people that. We're a product of our own impatience. I am. I'm an impatient bugger. And I'm not real gentle either. And my horses don't make me show my impatience, and they don't make me show my hardness. I'm not different than anybody else. But I do know the value of weight. Wait for the change. After all, I'm bigger, older, and fatter than I used to be, and I don't bounce no more. And I'm a pulp now.
Grandpa.
I'm a pulp. Now I look at every one of my horses different. Is this a horse that my grandson can hop on? If not, why is it? And I used to think, is this a horse that I can ride? It's changed now. I've got to find horses that allow my grandson to be safe. Some of my requirements are a lot more aimed towards getting horses more ready. It's not that tricky to hop on any horse inside a couple of hours. That doesn't mean it's all right. Doesn't mean it's a good thing. I did win a fairly good buckle for getting on a horse inside an hour and a half. That was called the way of the horse.
You've got 10 minutes.
All right. I was just about ready to put a saddle on. But we don't need to. You've seen the change. But I will get the horse ready for the girth. Hey, that is the reason that you're having trouble. She's girthy. She's just going all tight again. And I'm going to move her a little. I'm going to use the rope to tell her to go. There's the buck. See her head's going back up. She's going all six-legged again. There's the buck. And there's the reason she's learned to put her head up. Who knows why, but sometimes, a good percentage of the time, it's because we screw the girth down too quick. We just throw a saddle on and jerk it up until it's as tight as it can be so as we can get on, and heaps of horses damage their girth muscles because of that. That little red horse there, I'm hoping his girth isn't real tight right now.
No, it isn't.
Because he's a little bit the same. He shuts his front legs down when the girth is shut tight and too much. Yeah, Charlie, you're doing okay now. I wonder what'll happen if the saddle slips. Oh, that probably upsets you a little. Wonder what happens when I put my legs on. That's not too bad. That's pretty good. I won't take it any further back because she would chuck a wobbly. She doesn't need to do that. There you go. Man, she's good. She'd be ready to put a girth on now. Notice she lowers her head when she takes the first step. Before, she lifted her head. Isn't it easy to prepare a horse for the next step? All we've got to do is think. You can see the change. Now that's not going to stay unless we do something about keeping it there. It'll go back. It'll only take 10 minutes for it to go back if we don't do some sort of preparation stuff. But she's a nice one. It wouldn't be hard for it to stay. All we've got to do is work her a little bit. This much time on the ground for this much riding. And then slowly it changes over. They're not designed. The ground skills aren't designed to keep you on the ground. They're designed to get you on with a more element of safety more than anything. We haven't done all the ground skills yet. Only the sidestep. Pretty dry, isn't she? She's just got to get some weight off her and get some energy off her. She's like me, a fat person. She's fairly reasonable. She's starting to see the potential that she's got if we don't. She wants to be alright. Horses don't have trouble. Sometimes they can't sidestep trouble. That'll do it. Sorry we didn't get her any further, but you could see the change. You could see the change start. What did you get from that place? I know it was a little bit hard to follow in places. Just saw the connection between the soft jaw and the soft pole. Just saw a connection between the soft pole and the soft back leg. You're starting to see nothing can be separated. Everything means something. It's all cause and effect. It's just biomechanics. Stop thinking of yourself as a horse trainer, you're just a biomechanically manipulator. Shoot that leg over there. When I bump you on the nose, that says back up. When I bump you under the jaw, that says shift your front end. When I bump you on the top corner of the nose, that says shift your back end. That halter means something to it now. Make sense? When a touch of behind the ears and under jaw, that says come forward. On the top of the nose says back up. Under the jaw says front end. Top of the jaw says back end. She's got enough steer and enough softness that I could ride her in the hole. I think something was dumb. We ride it, but we work our horses until they're stuck and they're heavy in the halter, and we drag them from pillar to post and we're hauling on them, and then we expect to be able to ride them safely in the halter. Reasonable assumption says if they lean on you in the halter, they're going to lean on you when you ride them. That's not that hard to follow, is it? You need your horse to be inside that halter. Then you could probably ride him in it. He shouldn't wait for the halter to pull him. He should move before the halter pulls him. Then you could definitely ride him in the halter. Now I'm one of those people that do ride my horses in a bosal. I don't ride my own horses in a halter very much because I feel like the halter collapses too much around their face. I like more the substance of a bosal. But I will spend a couple of years in a bosal, then a couple more years in a snaffle, and then when they're ready, I might go up into a shank. But I know that I want to ride my horse for the rest of his life and not hold up. But if you want to, that's fine, go for it. I think it's like eating under there so at the top of your cheeks. Makes sense, guys. If you want your horse to be able to be ridden in a halter, don't go make him soft. Don't make him heavy and don't make him resistant, because when he gets to his darkest place, you're going to be the one that rides him. And sometimes you do have to go for the ride. More preparation needs done. What'd you get from that, guys? You can visibly see it.
Yeah, and you tickle their tummy muscles.
Yeah. She's a little different to the horse that come in, huh? Now, look at the blinker. That's not a bad deal. And I don't know that I want to take the credit. It was just the time spent with her moving around until she relaxed. Make sense? Just keep her moving. Laterally is better than forwards. Backwards is better than forwards. Sideways and backwards will make a horse tired quicker than forwards at any time. It takes a lot of energy for a horse to go south, sideways and backwards, because it's not gates they would normally volunteer, so they don't have muscles. They don't have muscle definition to be able to go backwards and sideways. That's why we've got to do a little bit of it often until their muscles develop to the camp. Stand up to get a horse to do a kind of half mark, because mainly their muscles aren't there to do it. They can do it for a couple of steps. Make sense? It's not a gait that they would just say, oh, you go back up now. They might take a couple of steps backwards to turn to run away from something, but that's about it. The better your horse backs up, the better he'll stop. Yeah, she's all right. There's not much wrong with her, is there? She just needs a little bit of help. She just needs a little bit of help from the biggest thing. Get the goddamn energy out of her. Get the gas tank to a place that fits her. That's the biggest thing for any of us. Get your gas horse's gas tank to a place that suits his level of training and suits your level of ability. It's not that tricky. We don't have to be that great, we've just got to get some wet saddle blankets on. What'd you get? Don't you say that it's easy? Well, it's easy. Simple, but not easy, I guess. You can see that it's possible for all of us to make a horse of our dreams. We've just got to get off our ass and go do it. If you didn't, you aren't get it by wishing. But you can get it by going and looking, and then starting to be proactive about it. The horse of your dreams is not the black stallion running down the beach. What are we going to do? Go straight on?